अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर ऑल फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल एट होम। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक यूनिट नंबर 1, द सेवियर ऑफ मैनकाइंड। द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस चैप्टर आर, इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू नाउ एंड लर्न अबाउट द मिशन ऑफ होली प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम। Also learn how his teachings changed the world. We also learn about condition of Arabia before Islam and how Islam changed the lives of the people. Here are the words meaning related to this chapter. So let's start from the paragraph number 1. In paragraph number 1, the writer described the land of Arabia. He is explaining the magnetism of Arabia land. Its ornamented and massless sky strikes the eyes. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born in this land, in the city of Makkah, which is about 50 miles from the Red Sea. Paragraph number 2 is all about the extraordinary memory, language specialities, and about festivals. Extraordinary memory, fluency, and outstanding expressions were some of the traits found in the Arabic poetry, and Ukaz festival was a well-known poetry competition of old times. And the Arabs possessed a remarkable memory and were an eloquent people. In paragraph 3, the writer discusses the civilization of that time. That in the 5th and 6th centuries, mankind stood on the verge of course, seeing that the civilization which had taken 4,000 years to grow started crumbling. And at this point in time, Allah Almighty raised a prophet from among themselves who was to lift the humanity from their ignorance into light of faith. Paragraph number 4 is all about the meditation of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that at the age of 38, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam favored loneliness and he focused his mind in silence, especially for religious reason, in the cave of Hira. Paragraph number 5 is about the kindness of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the period of waiting had come to a close. His heart was overflowing with profound compassion for humanity. He had a pressing urge to eradicate wrong beliefs, social evils, cruelty and injustice. The moment had arrived when he was to be bestowed with prophethood. Paragraph number 6 is about the divine message and mission of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the flow of the divine message which continued for the next 23 years had begun. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had arisen to proclaim oneness of God and the unity of mankind. His mission was to destroy the nexus of superstition, ignorance and disbelief, set up a noble conception of life and lead mankind to the light of faith and divine bliss. Paragraph 7 is about the belief that this belief was threatening their dominance in society, and the pagan Arabs started to mount pressure on the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers. They wanted them to renounce their cause and take to idol worshipping. Paragraph number 8. In paragraph number 8, the Holy Prophet's uncle was so impressed with his nephew's firm determination That he replied that, son of my brother, go thy way, none will dare touch thee, I shall never forsake thee. In paragraph number 9, the writer is telling us that, is telling us about our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he encountered all the challenges with great grace and dignity. In no time he elevated man to the highest possible level in both spiritual and worldly domains. He was also a driving force behind Arab conquest, which have created an everlasting impression on human history. No wonder he is universally acknowledged as the most influential figure in society history. In fact, as the driving force behind the Arabs' conquest, he may well rank as the most influential political leader of all the time. The Arab conquest of the 7th century have continued to play an important role in human history down to the present day. Paragraph 10 is about the Holy Prophet's deep faith in Allah Almighty, his love for humanity, and to the nobility of his character. Indeed, his life is a perfect model to follow. In reply to a question about the life of Holy Prophet Hazrat Muhammad, Hazrat Aisha Rizillahu Ta'ala Anha said, his morals and characters are an embodiment of Holy Quran. At the last, I am going to discuss the theme of the chapter. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last prophet of Allah Almighty, has the greatest influence on mankind. His teachings and his life is a source of motivation and guidance for humanity. Thank you.